More steps are being taken to avert shutdown of the aviation sector in Nigeria. As part of efforts, the Nigerian National Petroleum Company, NNPC, the Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, and the airline operators have agreed to provide 6 million liters of aviation fuel, as also known as Jet A1, at 480 naira per liter for 3 months, 480 naira per liter. The agreement was reached at the end of a meeting summoned by the House of Representatives to avert the planned shutdown by airline operators after their complaints that aviation fuel has reached an all-time high of 700 naira per liter. Meanwhile, the Independent Petroleum Marketers Association of Nigeria, IPMAN, has asked Nigerians to prepare for the worst fuel crisis in the country. At a press conference in Kano, the state chairman of IPMAN, Bashir Damalam, asked the federal government to prevail on the Nigerian Midstream and Downstream Petroleum Regulatory Authority to pay their outstanding bridging claims amounting to over 500 billion naira. Let's start from this aviation fuel, Jide. 470 naira per liter for three months to just cushion the effect on these airline operators.
Clearly, the airlines have told us that things are really terrible now. Something that was sold in the region of 220-something naira per liter suddenly went to 700 naira per liter. It's just similar to what's going on with diesel. How do they cope when fuel alone is now accounting for more than 70% of their operational costs? That's just no way they will survive. And this sector, even when we slipped into recession in 2016, this sector and the agri sector were the two sectors that had positive marks.
Yeah.
Were the two sectors that appear to be carrying our country, or doing well within the economy. Now, we are watching things go bad for the aviation sector. If this matter is not handled carefully, these airlines will go under. Already, I was reading about the oldest airline in our country that had already been under management, you know, finally going under. I was just wishing that that story was not true. Now, this. We've had other airlines that have died in the last few years, but we just can't allow this to happen. These people are saying that they can't overprice tickets beyond the reach of Nigerians. Nigerians do not want to travel by road anymore because the roads are not safe. So a lot of them are opting for air travel. But if we make air travel too expensive, patronage will drop. And when patronage drops, the airlines will not make enough money and they will start dying one after another. I saw the meeting, I watched the meeting that they had with the House of Reps, the first one, presided over by the Deputy House of Reps Speaker, Wase. I watched it. And I thought that at that time a solution would be found, because the airline said, permit us to import Jet A1 by ourselves. They were confident that if they were given the license to import Jet A1 by themselves, even if it is temporary, that things will not be this bad. Now, the question that has been agitating my mind is, if it is possible to sell at 480, how come? Because if this 480 covers landing costs, then how come we are going to sell at 700 and endanger the... In fact, if we are not careful, when airlines struggle like this, the lives of travelers, passengers, could be at risk because they will cut corners. Let's face it, they will cut corners. And we don't want to see a situation in which airlines will now be buying adulterated Jet A1. No. Planes will come down if that should happen.
God forbid.
Because in season of scarcity, that happens. So we have to be careful. I commend the House of Reps for their concern over this matter. But I hope that the NNPC will do what they've been told to do and save this critical sector from collapse.
Olanika.
It's the same thing everywhere. If the CBN would do what it's supposed to do, you know that even at that meeting, the last one that they held, the CBN governor sent a representative and they sent him away before the CBN governor himself came. All this needs that a critical sector is here. And if there's anything the government will have to do to save this sector from collapse, there's a need to do it. There are opportunities that need to be harvested, low-hanging fruits. And at this point, the government must act. Why is it that this Jet A4 and diesel, what exactly is the situation? Why is it going up, flip-flopping here and there? Something has to be done to save those critical sectors. Because there was an argument sometime online. People were saying that, no, because it's big people who fly, they will solve the problem and all that. It is no longer an elitist thing. Yes. It's just like the phone. It is no longer an elitist thing.
Everybody is flying.
Everybody and values just as his you life. Said, it is a critical aspect of the economy that the government must do something. If it means giving them the license and you monitor them to ensure that when you give them foreign exchange or the license or whatever, they don't import something else or overshoot what they are saying they will import, something has to be done. It is critically important for us to make sure this is done.
Julie, the 500 billion naira bridging claims by the Nigerian Midstream and Downstream Petroleum Regulatory Agencies, you know, to pay their outstanding debt. Can you tell us what we mean by this bridging claims?
Now, the government has what is called Petroleum Equalization Fund.
Okay.
The whole essence of the Petroleum Equalization Fund is to ensure that petrol is sold at the same price in every part of Nigeria. The price is regulated.
Mm.
It's actually Lagos. You lift everything. Everybody's coming to
Lagos. Come to Lagos to lift it.
We no longer send
this is through the pipeline.
Through the pipeline, because those boys are always waiting, and those storage facilities that President Buhari built back then as a military.
They have all been.
Yes, we are not really using them these days. Because how do you even get to use them? So now you pay, tankers come from the north to lift petrol from the different tank farms here in Lagos. Some of them spend like 3 days on the road before they get to Kano, or more days before they get to Maiduguri, all of these places. Now, the only way they can go through all that pain, they can subject themselves to all that grueling process is when you pay them the cost of transportation and all that. There's money that is given to them to take care of the cost of traveling to and fro. So that is what is called bridging. Bridging is the alternative to sending petrol through those pipelines. They know how to come and bring their tankers, but you must pay. So they are saying now that they have bridging claims totaling 500 billion. As I saw that figure, I was shocked. Because how could we allow the cost to rise up to this level? And these guys know that once that sector is deregulated, they will never be able to, no one will pay these claims anymore, these claims anymore. Some of them, their tankers fall by the side of the road, and all of these things.
Very dangerous.
Yes.
Driving from Lagos to Maiduguri, driving from Lagos to Sokoto.
Dangers involved in this bridging process, coming all the way to this place and going back and all that. So those costs are borne by the government, all in the desire to ensure that in every part of Nigeria, the price of petrol is regulated. So now they are saying that they have claims that have not been paid, totaling 500 billion. And they are saying that has to be paid. Otherwise, we'll face another round of petrol scarcity. Nobody wants the kind of suffering that comes with petrol scarcity in our country. Nobody wants to go through it. So whatever they can do, even if this payment will be made in tranches, they've got to do it.
Right. Okay, I want to thank you. Olayinka Oyebele, you told me about a traffic officer last month, Lagos State.
Yeah, you know, when people
traffic
do
management agency,
bad, we censor them. But when they do good, I think we should also commend them. This morning in the peak traffic of Ikorodu Road, I had a flat tire, and it was a last month official that stopped me and said, "Sir, you have a flat tire." I said, "No, I'm just looking for a place to park and amend it." And he stopped me and said, he cleared the road for me to make a reverse. And after I reversed, he showed me where to get
the organizer
who did it for me and said, so after that, the Oga, Mr. Festus Adesina, he just came and he didn't see me before then. He approached me and said, "Sir, your face looks familiar." I said, "Oh, have I committed any crime before?" He said, "No. I see you on Journalist Anger." I said, "Yes." He said, "Oh." And he ensured that everything was done and said, "Oh, please extend my greetings to BKU and Ayo Otitoju and Ayo Ozubaku." The moral lesson in this is that when we talk that people are bad, they should not think that we are saying that because
we don't hate them.
We don't hate them. Festus Adesina, the team leader of
Antony. Thank you.
You are great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You are doing a great job. Keep it up.
All right. I'm BKO.
You know, our friends in RRS too, they do that.
The good boys.
That's why they are the best in the country.
Yeah. And that's our package today. Join us tomorrow for another episode of the program. You can watch the repeat broadcast tonight at 11. And join us on Journalist Hangout on Sunday by 1:30 to 3:30 p.m. Well, youtube.com/TVCNewsNigeria. I'm Ayodele Uzubakun. See you tomorrow, and God bless Nigeria.